Hey everyone, it's just Tilly and me here today, and she's having a nap under the dinette. Today's video is a special one, an interview we had with the site supervisor, Simon Lewis, at the fantastic Ellesmere Port location. Simon shared insight of replacing lock gates, and we even got to take a peek at the work being done down inside the lock. It was a unique experience, and we're excited to share it with you. Oh, and if you're keen to explore more about lock gates and canal life, there's another excellent video by David of Cruising the Cut, and I'll drop it in the description below. Enjoy!
What's your job here?
My job, I'm a site supervisor.
I work for direct services under Canal and River Trust. I have a small team, five lads. Okay. And our area starts there, just by that boat, and it goes all the way through to Whitchurch, down to Middlewich. There's so, another Middlewich arm. Do you know the canal?
Yeah, we do.
Yeah, the Middlewich arms.
Yep.
And we go all the way up to Whitchurch, I said Povies.
Okay.
Lock there, that's our area. We also cover the River Weaver. Well, basically, this job entails the bottom gates were failing.
Okay.
The boards had gone, so we've had to replace them.
How old were they? Can I film from here? Is that all right?
Yeah, they were probably 15 to 16 year old.
Wow.
Oh, that's not very old, is it?
No, it's not very old. We normally like them 25 year old. If they're not used a lot, they can last a lot longer. We have the new gates made. These are from Brazy in Wolverhampton.
Okay.
They are delivered by road to us and put onto our tug and hopper. We bring them down here. We've only got the tug and hopper here because there's another stoppage higher up.
So
we had to get this delivered before Christmas.
Okay.
Because we couldn't get anything through here. Basically, we come. You can see all the safety we got to go through nowadays.
Yeah.
All the edge protection. It takes a third of the job is setting
safety.
Aside,
I can understand that.
It's quite a drop, isn't it?
This is a deep lock. If you want to come onto the bridge, you'll see a standard stop planks.
Right.
That you can see at the bottom.
Yes.
That's how we can shut the lock off.
Yes. Yep.
Each one is separate. There's 12 here.
Okay.
Then normally is only 7.
Right.
So it is quite deep.
This is deep. Yes.
And they're what? They're almost a foot in height?
They're not a foot, eight to 10 inches. They're about 10 inches.
Yeah.
Yeah, we've seen them stacked along the canals various places.
Every lock had its own locks.
Yes.
Planks in on site. But for some reason, they don't like it anymore.
Huh.
They were getting stolen as well.
That's a shame.
They're brand new.
Okay.
So you're well safe. They're not going to. They're not going to break.
So in terms of hanging, fitting and hanging the new gate, so the gates are delivered. They're craned in.
Basically we come in. The boat with no sides, a hopper. They're flat in it.
Yeah. Okay.
This one with the gantry, you can see. It's a 3-ton gantry, electric hoist.
Right? Okay.
I don't do any chain work now, you know what I mean?
And roughly what's the weight of a gate?
A weight of a gate is a ton and a half.
Oh, wow.
Just under a ton and a half.
That's a lot of weight, isn't it?
Yeah, it's in kilos, it's 1,467 or something like that. It is carved in.
Yeah.
The gate.
So we know. Is it? Okay.
I'm sorry, you can't get down there.
No, that's fine.
But if you looked on the gates, it's usually routed into it.
I've seen that on gates before.
So we know the weight. So they don't come with beams, of course.
Now, how long does it normally take to put a gate up? Just each gate?
Each gate, the crew, you can see here, I think there was 4 of us a day.
Oh, that's not bad.
We came in with the tug into here, with it in water.
Yes.
Yep.
This edge protection isn't up. Because we're allowed to work without edge protection when there's water.
Right. Yep.
We sail under the gantry, we lift it up, and it comes. We don't tie the boat off, because if you notice, we lift the lift of gate up, the boat will come out till it gets vertical.
Okay.
Yeah.
because it's a lightweight one, you can quite easily pull the gantry to the gate, which we don't want. It will be on its side.
Right.
So we let the boat do the work, you know what I mean?
Yep.
Float out.
Yep.
It's a lot safer.
Okay.
Then we put it at the front of the gate on the floor. Then we do the same, put it against the wall, tie them off so they're safe.
Yep.
Then we go out, and we by this time we've already taken the old beams off, put them on the side.
Yep.
They go for timber that are logging.
Yeah.
Then we lift the old gates out, and we do the same in reverse. We put it in the boat, the bottom hits it, and then we let the boat naturally take in it so the chain block stops vertical all the time.
Okay.
Right. Okay.
Not vertical, horizontal, sorry.
Okay.
Because again, it will pull the gantry over. We have had it, not on my site, but it has happened.
Okay.
Then once that's done, we put the stop lights in then. We pump out. It's 2 4-inch pumps under where we're stood.
Yep.
They're run by the pump over there on that trailer. All hydraulic.
Okay.
The pipes are here going out. The water's going into the other lot. There's a small amount of water comes in.
Where does this lead out to?
This leads out to the Manchester Ship Canal.
Okay.
That is the last lock on our patch, as you can see in the thing.
Gotcha. Okay.
Around the corner, the council run a much larger lock.
Okay.
But that is closed at the moment.
It's cool that he's got that going.
Yeah. Yeah. That's
well balanced, isn't it?
Yes. Yes.
I mean, to be able to move 1,400 kilos with one hand.
Yeah. No, they're balanced. They're fairly well balanced.
Yes.
Do you want to come lower down?
That would be great. Yep.
Just head off down right into the bottom. You can have a look at the top gates that are the same.
So this is the deepest I've ever been in a lock.
Now under the water.
Yeah, absolutely.
We're under the water.
This is the deepest.
This is about normal low level of water.
Yep.
And once the planks are out, it's never any lower.
Yes, that makes sense.
So you must get a lot of silt build up in the bottom of the locks as
well. I'm afraid we normally like you to get closer.
Yeah.
But when we dewatered this one, there is that much silt.
Yeah.
Yep.
And to be honest, the funding, there isn't funding to remove that. It's classed as hazardous waste.
Oh, yeah. Is it?
So as soon as we get it on a wagon, the pound signs start reeling.
Yeah.
Why is it? Is that because
it's possibly because it's going to have hydrocarbons in it, but you might also, there's not going to be any oxygen down here.
No. If you noticed, we've done a gas detector so we can come down here. There's no gas down here.
Right.
Yeah.
It's quite a flow of air in here, but we do that before we come in.
That makes sense.
But that is I know it is. It's 3 meters deep. That's 3 foot deep.
Wow.
Just over a meter.
Wow.
Because I had to come through my waders.
It's hard to say what's under all that.
To get to the pump.
Right.
To set them up.
Yeah.
It's hard work.
I can imagine.
So he's putting new paddocks.
Everything. That gate comes with everything
with
new.
With everything new.
Yeah, we're not putting them on. They come fitted.
Okay.
They're plastic paddles, as you can see.
Yep.
Wow.
Some are oak paddles.
Yeah.
2x2. But they are. I think they're the Kayox or coax paddles, plastic.
Okay.
The gearing's not on, of course. There's new gearing
on
that pallet out there.
Yep.
You'll see it on the top.
A pretty good fit on those gates. There's not
already.
Not much of a gap.
You can see how it's touching at the top.
Yeah, just a little
bit. And not the bottom. We use an alligator saw. You wedge them too. And then we'll get either a ladder or a scaffold, preferably a scaffold. And he cuts down them. Every cut, we'll probably bring that gate in by 50 mil.
A
3 mil cut and saw brings it in.
Yeah, because of the angle.
That's it. And every time it keeps cutting until you get
a good
complete
close.
Seal.
Yeah.
Even if you wander off a bit, it'll still be a seal.
It'll be
you know,
because
it'll mirror image on both gates.
Yeah.
Once you've done that, you can start fitting the what they call it, coin liners.
Yep.
On the heel post. Then you're getting very close. Then you see the timber that he's standing on.
Yep.
Yes.
That is the sill.
Okay.
I don't know whether you've ever heard when they'll come in, you can't get through your lock and the sill isn't sealing.
Yeah.
What it is, there'll be a twig or a tire stuck against that and the gate.
And the gate won't
gate
shut.
Won't shut.
And then they're trying to move it and knock it below the gate to get you. That's all the sill is. It's on a mitre shape, it's on a triangle shape.
Yep.
The liners are removed. There's the liners. They actually put them for you. They're the old liners. So that is the seal on the bottom of the gate.
Okay.
What they'll do, again, every time the mitre's been put, they've fitted the heel liners to the coins, which are the curves on the side. Then they'll put these some new coin sill liners in.
Yep.
And then what they do, they
show his hands.
Sorry, they wedge them. They wedge them off the sill and push them to the gate, so they haven't got to plane them, so they'll be that tight. Then they screw them down with stainless steel coach bolts. They're about 240 long. People say, "Oh, is it stainless because they don't rust?" But it's basically because of the strength.
Yeah.
If we use steel ones, our guns snap them,
and then you
have to start drilling another hole.
It's the tensile
properties of them.
Yeah.
It's nothing to do with that's why we use them.
Yeah, yeah.
And then we grout it. We mix cement, just basically cement and water, and they run it all behind so it fills any gaps.
Yep.
So there's no give on them liners then.
Right. Do you have to use sort of special cements?
Just normal, regular cement that you lay bricks on.
Yeah.
Okay.
If we had timber liners, these are stone, sorry, coins. If we put new coins on, which is a big piece of timber, there'll be gaps behind that. We do the same. We mix the cement into like a slurry. It's really like water, and we tip it behind them.
Right.
And it fills all them gaps up. Yeah. When it sets, it's a solid thing.
Yeah.
It's very hard to plane to fit walls.
I can imagine.
Yeah, so that's basically it.
How long do you have to wait for a new gate?
They can put a gate together within a few weeks.
Okay.
But they have that many of them.
Yeah, they're waiting
planned.
List.
We have engineers that go around and tell us. We're told what gates we're
right.
replacing.
Yeah.
The engineers decide and they have a plan, and I think it's drawing it for a year plan.
Okay.
So they know what gates they're going to do.
Necessary.
They will tell the repair yard probably 2 years in advance,
okay.
so they can start ordering their timber.
Right.
So at oak at 2,800 kilos altogether for
yes.
the pair of gates.
Yeah. More with the balance beam.
So
that's
talking,
without balance beam.
You're talking a serious amount of money, aren't you?
Yeah.
I'm going. I haven't asked this year, but they used to be £28,000.
Wow.
For the two leaves.
Wow.
Okay.
And everything that goes with it. The
yes.
job. The job of doing this and setting up is probably more like 56,000.
Yeah.
Right. With five of us, like with everything
right.
in.
Right.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. With a lot of gear.
A lot of safety equipment.
Everything's gone up this
safety
year.
Safety equipment.
Yeah. Everything's gone up everywhere.
The diesel.
Yes.
And people
sometimes
still need to be paid for their work.
Yes.
Yes.
They?
Yes. The diesel, those pumps are running 24/7.
Yeah. We hope you enjoyed the video. If you have, please like, comment, and share. And if you're new to the channel, subscribe and click the bell to be notified when we put up new content. Stay tuned for more insightful and interesting interviews at the Ellesmere Port National Waterways Museum location. See you soon!